Gamers help science big time. More than 250,000 gamers have helped one of America's leading universities find out more about neurons. The Princeton University Eyewire project saw 265,000 gamers help map more than 3,000 neural cells into a digital museum. How did they do that? Well, put simply, they gamed. The research project had players tracing out the structures from ganglion cells in a mouse's eye. Princeton research scholar Shang Mu said these cells are the connection between the retina and the brain. Gamers mapped this by coloring 10 million 3D cubes. These cubes, according to Princeton University, are 4.5 microns across, meaning a 10 by 10 block is the width of a human hair. All mapped cells are verified by up to 25 other gamers, and once it's complete, they're entered into the Eyewire Museum. To make it fun, gamers could win achievement badges and can chat to others. Princeton says they play for around 30 hours a week. What's even more amazing is that those gamers have been working on this since 2009. Here's more gaming stories.
Achievement unlocked. For the first time ever, gaming addiction is set to be classed as a health issue by the World Health Organization. According to a draft definition, symptoms of gaming disorder can include continuation or escalation of gaming despite negative consequences. It can also be shown by the gamer exhibiting impaired control over gaming and/or by more time being given to gaming, to the extent that it takes precedence over other important life aspects. And it's not like gamers can just go cold turkey. We mean, have you seen how they handle poultry? These symptoms have to go on for a year for a diagnosis to be assigned, but that time can be shortened depending on the severity of the gaming.
Oh, this is rare. A copy of the legendary Sonic the Hedgehog 2 was mysteriously purchased by someone in March from a game store that has been carrying it since 1992. Covered by Tech Times, video game industry analyst Matt Piscatella tweeted that he was surprised to see Sonic the Hedgehog 2 for the Sega Game Gear pop-up in his sales report. Intrigued by the phenomena, Piscatella sent out a tweet hoping people on the interwebs could help him out. However, he wasn't able to immediately get any more info. This led to one theory saying that the game popped up in a Toys R Us as a sell-off, which makes sense, no? A relative of the mysterious buyer retweeted Piscatella and said it was his brother-in-law who bought the game at a store in Wisconsin for just $6.99. And apparently the game was purchased in February and they thought they could play the game with their Sega Game Gear. Sadly, the console didn't work properly. According to Game Rant, since its existence, the Sega Game Gear has totaled 10.62 million units in sales worldwide. It was later forced out of the video game market by Nintendo Game Boy as it was bigger. Well, guys, do you prefer Game Gear or Game Boy?
Blockchain-based GLN wants to battle Steam and Apple Gaming. Let the gaming begin. And sure, another new cryptocurrency couldn't hurt. Game Loot Network Holdings is planning to use blockchain technology to create an alternative gaming market and player reward system to challenge Steam and Apple in the PC and mobile gaming market. GLN will use blockchain to handle transactions and its cryptocurrency Loot as part of its reward system. According to Digital Trends, GLN has raised $2.5 million in pre-sales, but will hold an initial coin offering on May 29th. The company said during a test run, they saw 5 million in transactions and had 65,000 users. GLN will also offer a platform called Build to let independent game developers submit game ideas, story concepts, and demos, which will also allow gamers to support developers using the Loot digital currency.
World's hottest PC game to get locked out of China. PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds may be a smash hit everywhere in the world, but leave it to China to take aim at the survival video game's violent content. Gameplay in Battlegrounds is Hunger Games style. It starts with players parachuting into a desert island, scavenging for all sorts of weapons, and then fighting each other to the death. Last man standing wins. Despite not yet officially launching in China, the game already has a sizable chunk of Chinese players. But with regulators complaining of too much blood and gore, it looks like Battlegrounds won't be getting a license anytime soon. If it does, expect it to be heavily cut and censored to fit socialist core values and traditional Chinese culture. Fun! The Chinese Copyright Association may not be a fan of violently competitive games, but better violent in a game than in real life, which might be the case if the players get fed up with their policing. Game over. A Chinese gamer was recently left paralyzed from the waist down after playing games for 20 hours at a cyber cafe in China's Zhejiang province. According to China's viral news site, QQ, the gamer started the marathon session on the evening of January 27th and kept playing till the afternoon the next day. He only realized he could not move his legs when he tried to get up from his chair to go to the toilet. Despite the condition he was in, the gamer begged his buddy to complete the unfinished game while being wheeled away. In a report conducted by South China Morning Post, China currently has about 565 million gamers, and in 2008, the country officially declared internet addiction a clinical disorder, which could result in addicts being confined to video game boot camps until they don't want to play anymore. Is Pokemon coming to the Nintendo Switch? Pokemon fans are lit online over alleged leaks of a possible new online-driven Poke title that might be coming to the Nintendo Switch. It all goes back to when game industry scoopster Emily Rogers blogged that the name of the new Pokemon game might be revealed by the end of May. According to IGN, several hours after news of that came out, a 4chan user posted this image. That user claims it'll be a remake of Pokemon Yellow, titled Pokemon Let's Go, with Eevee and Pikachu editions, with said elderly monsters being the starters in each. Interestingly, Red and Blue, characters from the 1996 original, are rumored to return. Nintendo told Kotaku they don't comment on rumors or speculation, but there may still be some legitimacy to it. Kotaku reports websites for PokemonLetsGoPikachu.com and PokemonLetsGoEevee.com were both registered by the same company acting as contact for Pokemon-SunMoon.com. Couple that with an earlier leaked screenshot of an Eevee and trainer riding a Lapras with this tweet from a verified Japanese Nintendo Project Eevee Twitter account, and it seems like the leaks may be legit. The 4chan leak also claims the game will feature integration and rewards with Pokemon Go. The House of N recently announced they're paid for Nintendo Switch Online service. Once that goes live in September 2018, online Switch play will no longer be free for games such as Mario Kart. So, if the news of this future Pokemon game on the Switch turns out to be true, it will be interesting to see if Nintendo will use it to make bank on their online services.